Welcome back to another episode of This Is My Architecture. Today I'm joined by Mohan from Purolator. Hey Mohan.
Hi, how are you?
So tell us a little bit about what Purolator does.
Yeah, Purolator is Canada's largest express courier company, and we process about 5 million packages every day, and we do both business-to-business and business-to-consumer. And on the B2C side, we are tied very much to things that happen in the B2C market, similar to Amazon Prime Day or Black Friday or Cyber Monday. And as we approach peak now, this is our holiday season as well. And we have a lot of peaks and valleys through the year.
So a lot more online shopping and e-commerce going on. That's also leading to a lot of digitization. What were some of the challenges that you had with your existing system?
You're right. In our existing legacy system, we had two problems that we were trying to solve. One was the reliability of the messages, and two was the scalability of what we had in place.
So how many packages do you process every day?
Yeah, we process about 5 million packages every day. But like I said, during our peak times, we do go scale up and down. So it's important that we have that elastic scalability.
Scalability is really important. I see a fantastic architecture that we're going to dive into. Tell us how it works.
Sure. Let's start with the life cycle of a package. When a customer declares intent to ship a package, they produce a label. And the moment they produce a label, that information is with us in our legacy system. And what we do is we take that basic information about a package, and it's a JSON message, essentially. We take that and process it into an SQS, in a queue. And a simple Lambda, which we call an ingestion Lambda, picks it up and essentially drops it into a relational form, into an RDS at the back that we have.
So inventory of your packages is really important. Can't afford to lose it. So using something like SQS gives you that reliability, right?
Exactly. We have it totally decoupled and scalable in terms of our queues and our compute.
Okay, so once you know about the package, what's going on over here?
Yeah, so on a package, there is a variety of events that happen through the package lifecycle. Typical events that happen are a pickup event, where a delivery or a pickup driver goes and picks up the package from the customer, and it travels through our network, through our facilities and so on, and gets to the customer's door eventually. And through that life cycle, it goes through, like I said, a few scans in the facility, as in we got the package in the hub or a terminal, and it's out for deliveries, another scan that we do, or an event that happens on the package, and then out for deliveries, another one. And delivered and signature required, et cetera, are all these events that happen.
So I see event processing here. Tell us a little bit about how that works.
Yeah, each event, like I was telling you about, has a different connotation and a different meaning to the company and to the customer. One of the interesting ones I'll talk about, but the generic event flow goes like this. Again, every event happens from a handheld that the pickup or delivery driver has, and that gets put into another SQS queue. And another Lambda pulls it off of the queue and then, again, processes it into a relational database at the back. But each of these Lambdas have a different flavor in what they do and what purpose they serve. And that is, for a pickup event, the processing is different as opposed to if you take, for example, a disruption scan, meaning a truck broke down somewhere in between. We need to know immediately so that we can actually let the customer know in real time that there may be a potential delay in getting the package. So each of these Lambdas react differently to different types of events that happen.
Yeah, so different queues, so you're actually separating a lot of your business logic and not coupling them, given you've got so many events every day.
That's right.
And of course, you know, you're not worrying about servers. Everything is completely serverless.
That's right.
Great. I see S3 here. What are you doing with that?
This is also an interesting use case for us. And like I talked about, the package travels through our network, and we capture several events throughout. And one of them is something we do in a terminal called redimensioning and weighing. So an example would be if you had declared a box to be 10 by 10 and 10 kilograms, and as it passes through this ARC machine, we reweigh it and we redimension it. So if we were to find that either the box was bigger or heavier or what have you, then that image is captured as well as a a revenue uplift scan is done on that package. And that image gets stored into an S3 bucket. And we take that image or create a link in our relational database to that image that was captured and put into an S3.
Right.
That gives you, if you look at this architecture here, a full view of a package and its life cycle. That's very, very critical to our
business.
You've
obviously got a single source of truth with this, with using RDS across that inventory as it goes.
That's right.
That's fantastic, Mohan. What are you thinking about next?
As you rightly mentioned, if we start to process more events and different sets of events, then we might want to think about doing some orchestration within that, and we're kind of looking at potentially the use of step functions,
mm-hmm.
as well as we would like our, since you said that this is our single source of truth, and we rely heavily on it for consumption of the back, is we would like to see if we can kind of isolate the writes and the reads, mm-hmm. and potentially scale the reads, read nodes through, you know, several read copies and
so
stuff.
So using
like that
read replicas cluster. Over here to help scale this front end.
That's right. Exactly. And we would drive our analytics and any kind of business intelligence out of those consumers. So we're looking at doing that in the future.
That's great, Mohan. It's a really good use of event-driven serverless architecture to go and help your customers deliver
right.
packages. Mohan, thank you for coming in and sharing your architecture with us today.
You're welcome. Happy to be here.
And thank you for joining us on This Is My Architecture.